on Saturdays. You would make such a pleasure.
Enjoy, celebrate, and relish, and appreciate this present moment that we have right now.
Operate. What is it that can be said? I mean, I find that like sometimes offering information, it just creates, you know, an adversary or a split versus, you know, trying to find like a common ground. Like what is it?
Well, we have a training in called the aPlantBasedDiet training. I mentioned it earlier, and it really focuses on days. I mean, there's an enormous amount of information. Yeah, at the bottom, I can't figure out what to eat and what to say to people, right? That's the hard stage of being a vegan, The second stage is the angry vegan stage, where now we know what to say to people, we know what to eat, but now we're angry all the time because we try to talk to people, and they don't change like we want them to. So we're frustrated, we're depressed, and we usually at that stage don't have a lot of spirituality going on, so we're trying to change people. And we can get stuck for years in that stage, and we can burn out. Some people burn out, and they don't want to do it anymore, and people even stop being vegan, unfortunately. But there's a third stage I call deep vegan. So this is when we bring the spirituality in, and we also bring an bigger understanding. That's again why I wrote the World Peace Diet. I wasn't able to do it this evening, but it takes a whole many hours to really show this big picture of our society, of our situation here. And when we understand this bigger picture, we're also cultivating direct awareness and becoming more conscious of ourselves as infinite spiritual beings, then veganism becomes an expression of who we are naturally. When we can get a glimpse that what we are is the infinite sky that has no boundary, that has no past or future. What we are was never born and will never die. And that becomes the foundation of our activism, then we never burn out. Because here we are, this body is not who I am, right? This is just a, in Buddhism, this is a footprint. If you see a footprint in the sand, like we're at the beach, you know, I've seen these footprints in the sand. If you don't go up to the footprint and say, "Hello, George, how you doing," right? That's just a footprint. That's not the person who made the footprint, right? This is the footprint waving. You can't see me. You'll never see me. I'll never see you. There's a being looking through the eyes, and it's the same thing. That's why these are so powerful. There's a being looking through those eyes. And when we wake up to that, we'll go vegan. Have you heard the story of the guy